Well, I'd like to understand that. I think it's part of the broader political thing that we have to do. We are a portable approach. We don't have people at the top of the Department of Education.
Most of you, not all of you here, you're part of what Dave calls the mission. And he always talks about, you know, we've got a mission, this is the mission. What is the mission? The mission to change people's life for the better. The mission to give them really good people stuff. And, you know, this is why it's so important for us to keep, you know, defining intensive instruction, to keep talking about how to sustain it, to make sure that we protect it.
Experienced intensive instruction practitioners decide what they should do in the moment and what to come next when engaging in intensive interaction with a range of people with a communication or social impairment, and get it right so often. I think that's the interesting thing. How is it that they can take in so much information and mainly, in a kind of trial and error decision-making process, end up making the right decision so often?
So therefore, you know, I'm talking to you from a owner-provider perspective here, and a manager's perspective, so therefore why use intensive interaction? Because it makes us a market leader, really. It sets us above the rest. It generates business. So you're writing notes now, aren't you? Go back to your managers and tell them. It generates business. It really, really has. This is something I've said to Dave in the past, isn't it, Dave? That intensive interaction has actually brought business my way. People have actually sought our services out specifically because we use intensive interaction. But it's brilliant because they're doing it and I'm spontaneously going into classes and I'm seeing it. They're not expecting me to walk in. They're doing it because they know that it works for their children and it works for them. It works for the setting. So that's fantastic.
In place, but we've recently submitted a bid to the Welsh Government and the positive signs are that that's likely to be approved in the spring of 2018. And kind of part of me feels that that would be quite a significant thing for the Welsh Government to recognise intensive interaction and the need for dedicated resources and pay for them themselves would be quite significant. For our work, really. So, you know, I'll keep you posted.
If you have got the skills and abilities to initiate, sustain and share and maintain that joint attention with another person, the world's your oyster. And I think you can all reflect back on children you support, young people you support, adults you support, and think, can they independently and spontaneously initiate, share, spontaneously engage? Can they do that without you? Prompt.
So, if we think about requisite touch, this is the touch that experiences, that students need to live their lives, what we consider normal lives. So, it's the transference, it's the nose wiping, it's the ability to access rebound or whatever. And what my passion is that those requisite touches are going to happen day in, day out for those individuals. But it's making each of those requisite touches nurturing. There is a very nurturing way to wipe somebody's face, and there's a very quick and efficient way to do it. And it's making sure that everybody's aware of how to do it, and putting the nurturing in where possible.
I'm not a teacher now. I think it's part of the broader kind of political thing that we have to do. We are a portable approach. We don't have people at the top of the Department of Education or the Department of Health, even though it is in some of their documentation, there are...